Very good morning to all, beta. We are going to revise poetry. Chapters of Beehive you have already revised. Fine. So in your first revision test, we have Beehive. Clear? First poem, The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. First of all, everyone, please learn the name of the poem and the poet also. Clear? The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. So now we'll be writing some points, value points. And we'll try to understand the poem and then we'll concentrate on the MCQs. I'll be sharing the screen here, okay? So the very first point is the poet Robert Frost, he is in a dilemma. The poet is in a, you can say, you can also call it, he's in a fix, F-I-X. In a fix or he's in a dilemma, you can say. What do you mean by in a fix? That when you have reached a turning point in your life and you have to choose one out of the two options, you have to make decision. Clear? So poet is in a fix or he's in a dilemma, fine. And he has reached a turning point. Why he's in a fix? Nobody will speak like that, but please. When I ask you a question, then you speak. So poet is in a fix and he has reached a turning point in his life. Clear? And why he's in a fix? Why he is confused? Because there are two paths before him. This poem was the first thing we did in the beginning of the term one. You remember? So the first period, I taught this thing only. So this is very necessary that you revise this. So two paths are there in front of him and he's confused at which path to be followed, which should he take and which path is going to make a difference, going to create a difference in his life. Fine. So he is supposed to take a decision. And the decision which he will be taking will affect his life. So poet is in a fix because turning point of his life, two paths in front of him. He's supposed to take one decision, clear? And he knows that this decision will make a big difference in his life. And one thing is very much clear to poet that he cannot travel both the roads. Obviously, being a single traveler, he cannot travel both roads. So that's why he has to choose one out of the two. Class 9th D, beta, you are in habit of joining late these days. The students who are at home. I have to send messages via WhatsApp. Then you people join. Keep an eye on your WhatsApp so that changes are quite clear to you. I need to send you reminders on daily basis. And one thing more, beta. You will be appearing for your listening test soon. Information will be put in the WhatsApp group only and that listening test will be of 6 marks. Clear? So you have to attempt all the questions based on just the way you attempt your revision test. And probably we are trying that on the same day you are appearing for the first revision test. Before that or after the revision test, we will be sending listening test also. So that on the same day, both things can be done. Clear? And you are not bothered for other days. So this is compulsory. All the revision tests as well as listening tests is part of your assessment. And jinki notebook abhi bhi reh gayi hai, kindly send it. Baad mein nahi kehna, meri assessment nahi lagi. And the ones who have not received back after checking, they can text me separately, individually. Fine, mujhe message kar dena so that I can see because sometimes we people misplace in between the PDFs. Fine. So he cannot travel both roads and if he takes a decision and goes forward, he's unable to go back also. And he also knows that he can't travel both roads. He can't mend his decision also. Means once a decision is taken, so this is the awareness of the poet Robert Frost. That he cannot travel both roads, he cannot mend his ways, he cannot mend his decision once made. So he thinks that one day he will be in a position to tell the story of his decision. Whatever decision he will be taking, he will be telling to the coming generations about the story of how he chose and the path which he will be, and which path he chose. He chose the road less traveled. He chose the path or road less traveled by others. There were two roads. One was grassy and wanted wear, means less number of people had trodden on it. And there was one road which was traveled by most of the people. So he chose less traveled by because he did not want to be part of the crowd, that whatever others are following, he should follow also. So he, not, but he wanted to be different. The thing is, he wanted to choose what he likes, what he prefers. So now there is one quote that difficult roads often lead to beautiful destinations. Have you heard about this? So difficult roads often lead to beautiful destination. Maybe that was in his mind, that with difficulties, a person becomes more stronger. So he chose less traveled road, fine. So, and he knew that he will be telling the tale, telling the story to the coming generation, that how he chose the less traveled path and how it affected his life. Clear? There is nothing particularly mentioned, fine, but you have to attempt the question. So I'll be asking you the questions first. Have you noted down the points, Vita? Now I'll be doing that. So you can see the screen, Vita. Avoid looking at the ads because there are a lot of distractions. Let me close the first question. What is the dilemma of the poet? What is the dilemma of the poet? Number one, whether he will be able to come back to second road or not. Option B, whether he will get time for himself. Option C, whether he will be successful in life, whether he will be able to walk. Yes, last girl, please tell me the answer. What was the dilemma of the poet? Whether he will be able to come back to the second road or not, whether he will get time for himself, whether he will be successful or not, whether he will be able to walk. Successful. You also say the same thing. Yes. What do you think? Yes. Who's saying option A? That is correct answer. He said that whether he will be able to come back to first road or not, that was his dilemma. Okay. So he wanted, he did not want to leave the first road also. He wanted to travel both actually, but being single, he had no choice. Fine. So he was thinking whether he will be able to come back to the second road or not. Second question. What does the poet's decision, what does the poet's decision of taking less traveled road signify? Option A, poet's risk-taking habit. Question clear sabko? Why did he choose less traveled road? What does it show about the poet? Poet's risk-taking habit. Option B, arrogance of the poet. Option C, poet's curiosity. Option D, poet's negligence. Yeah. Yes, poet's risk-taking habit. Option A is the answer. Yes, everybody has given the right answer. Poet's risk-taking habit. Other options do not imply here. Third question, what does the choice of road signify? choice of road signify too many things, two paths, toughness of a choice and decision in life, none of the above. What does the choice of road signify? There should be screens in your class also, I feel, because नहीं आपको भी how it gets connected even I'm not aware. Toughness of a choice and decision in life. Clear? Next time I'll use this option. In between the class, I'll not use the screen. Fine? Tomorrow we can try. Where does the poet find himself? He finds himself on the road, on a bus, on a muddy road, on a fork. On the road? Last option is the answer. Fork is a diversion. Fine, when two paths are divided. Clear? Now, online students, fine, on a fork is the right answer. What does poet's long stare at the path signify? He keeps on staring at the path. What does it signify? The time, I have not given any option, fine. The time taken by people to decide and making the choice. Poet loves nature. Then idling away the time. Relaxation hours. Very easy it is. The time taken by people to decide and making the choice. What to do? Nobody will speak now. Fine. Online children, better you can raise hand. What do yellow woods represent? You just see the options. Options are in front of you and raise hand. What do yellow birds represent? People, older people, poets, choice. You have to think about this. Yellow birds represent people, older people, poets, choice. Online students, I ask, you can raise hand in this. 22 students are here. Not a single hand raised. Then I'll be interacting with the offline children only. I gave you the chance. Otherwise, you will say, ki ma'am, humse nahi baat kar rahe. Yes, Brijesh. Older people is the right answer. They are saying yellow woods. When trees are turning yellow, leaves turn yellow and they fall finally. It means the aging process. Clear? Why was the poet able to travel one road only? Because the road he had to walk alone. He had no vehicle. He was one person. All of the above. All of the above. He was one person. Obviously, being single traveler, it is mentioned in the poem. Jo bhi answer dena hai, try to keep the context of the poem in mind. Why is the poet asking to be wise while choosing a pathway? Because there is no going back option. Because it is the only one road. Because it is one-sided road, none of the above. Yes, option A is the correct answer. Next question I'm going to speak. Online children can also raise hand. Which thing decides a person's future according to this poem? Fine, I'm going to speak the options now. I repeat the question. Which thing decides a person's future according to this poem? Option A. The path one chooses to walk. Option B, the path one leaves behind. Option C, the regrets. Option D, the success. Just raise your hand. Only two children know the answer, three. What about others? Yes, Titiksha, you can answer.
I'm option A. The path one chooses to walk.
Yes, correct answer it is. You can mute yourself. What was your Jia answer? The same? Fine, so this is very easy question. Now I'll be moving on to tough ones. What does the poem speak about? Now there are multiple things this poem speak about. Option A, about the plight of roads. Option B, about the two roads. Option C, about the choices. Option D, about the choices and decisions. Now see, all of the above maine diya hi nahi hai, that's why I'm saying there are three correct answers in this, but exact answer is about the choices and decisions, because firstly choice is there in front of you and then you make a decision about it. But in this, on my screen, there is no this choice which I have given myself. Clear? Next is, okay, next let's continue with the next poem now. Enough of questions we have done. We have next poem is, all the, we'll be doing literary devices all together to create confusion so that you know, fine? Rain on the roof. Finally, we'll be doing this now. Next poem. Rain on the roof se pehle bhi hai, wind hai, I guess. Next poem is wind. Page number 30 of your book. It is written by Subramania Bharati. Haanji beta. So let's write points of this poem first. I guess two poems in one lecture, not all the poems, fine. So we are going to revise point number two, wind. Learn the name of the poem and the poet with the spelling beta. Subramania Bharati. Firstly, we'll write Subra, then Mania. Bharati, Bharati. After R, we have A also. So let's write down the points. Very first point, the poet is actually making a request to the wind in this poem. Fine, it's a request or plea, P-L-E-A. Plea means we request you then. So what kind of plea it is making? Abhi likhna nahi, I'll make it right. Poet is making a plea. Why? That don't break. You know that wind's speed should not be too much. That it should not destroy the things around. It should not cause destruction. Fine. So right on the first point, the poet requests the wind to slow down its speed. The poet requests the wind to slow down its speed. Clear? So very first point is slow down. Beta, aage maine likha, it's a speed. Children, online children, for you are speaking. The poet requests the wind to slow down its speed. Fine. The wind breaks the shutter of the windows. Fine. What does the wind do now? I'm going to tell you. The potent window, the mighty wind. I'm not saying the word window, wind. The mighty, the potent, the strong, any word you can use, fine? The potent wind what does the wind do? Why poet is saying so? The potent wind breaks the shutter of the window. Breaks the shutter. You should know what does the wind do. Breaks the shutter of the window. Of the windows, scatters the papers. It also scatters the papers. Third thing, what does the window do? It also throws down the books on the shelf. Scatter the papers and throws down the books from the shelf. So these are the things done by wind, or you can say the mighty wind. Clear? It also tears the pages of the books and brings rain. Wind also tears the pages of the books. So you should know, you can get any option. What does the wind do? Three things are written and last mein likha hai, all of the above. One, what does the wind do? It tears the pages, it brings down the books, it breaks the shutters of the window, all of the above. All of the above answer. Fine, sometimes it is written shutters of the windows. Fine, scatters the papers. Fine, brings clouds, both A and B. Both A and B. So you should be smart enough to perceive, okay? Wind also tears the pages of books and brings rain. They have mentioned it in the poem. The next thing is the wind makes fun of the weak people. The wind makes fun of the weak. Bas weak tak likh lo. The wind makes fun of the weak. Makes fun of the weak. Brings rain. It also makes fun of the weak. Now, after the destruction caused by the wind and all, poet again turns back to the suggestion. Fine. So next point is the poet suggests the people that they should build strong houses. Poet's suggestion. Next point is, poet's suggestion is to build strong houses. Build strong houses. Poet's suggestion is to build strong houses. Why to build strong houses? So that they can face the wind. Fine. So last four lines of the poem, they conclude the poem. Message is very much clear that weak people are afraid of difficulties. Write down the last point. What is the message conveyed by poem? Write down message hyphen. Short mein likh lo, that will be easy for you. Message. Weak people are afraid of difficulties. Strong people make the way through them. Weak people, W-E-A-K, weak people are afraid of difficulties. Strong people way through it, through them. Them means difficulty. So difficult people, they go through the difficulties. Next is first MCQ of this poem. I'm not going to share the screen because I had not, made a folder of it here, or the site is not open. So let me just speak. Wind is a symbol of, first question. Wind is symbol of strength, cowardice, cowardice. Cowardice किसको बोलते हैं? डरपोक जो होते हैं उसको कोवर्ड बोल देते हैं. कोवर्डिस मीन्स द जो डरपोक होने. I'm just saying this is one of the option I'm giving, fine. Wind is symbol of cowardice, strength, difficulties, pleasure, L-E-I-S-U-R-E. Yes, Anaisa, what is the answer? Wind is symbol of strength. Ashna. Now you prove your point. Wind is coming in our lives. Fine. Is it a symbol of strength or difficulties? It is symbolic of difficult phase of our life. Kaise? Wind is not giving us the message here. Poet is saying wind will come into your life, but you have to build strong houses, means you have to become strong to face it. Fine. So wo strength thodi leke aa rahi hai. That is, yes, we will learn strength out of it if we will face difficulties. Actually, wind is symbolic of difficult phases of our life. Fine. So tabhi aise questions aane jahan pe confusion create hoegi aap. Clear? Baitho. Difficulties is the correct option. Next is, wind never spares dash. Wind never spares, S-P-A-R-E-S, dash. Option A, strong people. Option B, coward people. Option C, weaklings. Option D, all of the above. Weaklings, fine. So this is very much clear because it is mentioned in the poem. Next is, what were the ladies doing? I have not mentioned in the option A, sewing a dress. Option B, winnowing grain. Option C, crushing grain. Option D, none of the above. Winnowing. What do you mean by winnowing? Differentiate karna. Fine, segregate karna usme se. So you remember it. Very good. Next is, what is the message conveyed by this poem, Wind? Option A, we should face defeat in our life. We should set targets in our life. We should be determined and face obstacles. Option D, we should always be fearless. Kya hai wo? Yes, we should be determined and face obstacles in life. Fine. How much time is left? Last question is, what does this poem convey? Fine, it is kind of a message only. Option A, we must fight with difficulties. Option B, we should do friendship with the strong. Option C, wind likes to be the friend of the strong. And none of the above. Yes, option A. So you can get many sides from this, right? So I guess all the questions are covered.